I look back on 2020 here at the club, it was a hard one. Everybody was pushed beyond their comfort zones on all different type of levels, and we made it. We're doing it. Coming into the 2020 season, everybody was eager, chomping at the bit, to use that pun. We really had a great year in 2019, and I think a lot of us sat together, put some thought and poured our hearts into the 2020 season, and then COVID hit. And that kind of just knocked us all out of the saddle, so to speak. But I think something as a horsewoman, as an individual who is in the equestrian industry, is we know that when we get knocked off, we get back in the saddle and we learn from our mistakes and we try harder and we don't put blame on a situation or a horse or the environment. We figure it out, and that's exactly what we did here at FPC.
You deal with so many different types of horses. They all have different needs and personalities, and you know, we have some that come through and they're easy keepers, and then you have some that come through and they need more attention than the newborn baby, and it's not a 9-to-5, you know, you get a phone call in the middle of the night that somebody's out and running around, and we do it because we care, we love them. You know, they're our family, they're our kids. I may be 23 years old, but I've got 40 plus kids to keep an eye on, and it really gives you a sense of responsibility like nothing else in the world, you know, because they are completely reliant on you as animals that just, they depend on you for their food, their water, their care, and they open their hearts to you if you open your hearts to them and keep them safe and happy.
When it comes to polo, it's not just showing up on Saturday and then getting on the horse and playing, you know. It's 7 days a week. The horses depend on you to eat 3 times a day, you know, take care of them. It takes all week, hard work, all day to just make it so everything can be like perfection when it comes to Saturday.
Besides polo going on, we have our hunter jumper program. Johanna came on just under a year ago, and you know, it's grown tremendously. She's really taken off with it. She brought on an assistant this year. We're bringing in the youth and the community, and we're creating these futures for the riders and for the community to be a part of an equestrian program this way.
When COVID hit back in March, April, the program definitely took a dip. We couldn't do lessons here for about 2 months. So that was definitely a change. I and the staff was having to do the majority of the riding on our horses. But when the barn was able to open up again, people wanted to come out and ride. It was such a safe environment outdoors where they could kind of escape what was happening in the bigger world. We really saw a huge increase of students at that time. We probably went from about 10 to 15 students to now like 25, 30 students. And they just saw it as a great atmosphere where they could enjoy something outside and be safe.
I take pride in working with the kids so they can learn to love the horses. The thing I love most about working at the Farmington Polo Club is there's always something going on. It's exciting, there's not a dull moment. You have practices during the week and then events happening during the weekends, so there's always something to keep yourself entertained with. That's what I really like about it.
Farmington Polo Club, family first. Family in the barn, family outside of the barn, family when we go home. We could not do our jobs the way we do that if we didn't have the love and support from our friends and our family. That is something that all of us here, it's the heart of our work and it's our work ethic. And I think we're able to bring in the community and offer, you know, our charity events, our polo events, our equestrian events, because that's our focus. You are our focus. We want not just one person of your family. We want everyone to feel incorporated. We want that inclusion. Moving forward, Polo kind of taking an initiative to be that introductory, to open that door, to bring people on the property, to show them, hey, you know, this is a sport that you don't get to see. You know, it's only played so many areas to the public in the country, let alone the world. And it's a unique opportunity.
It's been an honor to be here and a pleasure to meet a lot of people, great people that love polo, and I'm happy and I'm glad that I came.
Something that I really enjoyed about Farmington is that everyone was really friendly. We were all having a good time. I mean, when we were out there playing, everyone wanted to win. Everyone was trying hard. Everyone was playing their hearts out to win and have a good game. And at the end of the day, after the game, we're all again friends. Something that I think that used to be common in polo, and that now you don't really see it much around.
Kind of like a faux celebrity status, I feel like sometimes. You know, I get these cute little girls that come up and it's flattering, they want your autograph. But it just to know for me, they push me on the field, that I know that anything that comes out of my mouth, the way I treat my horses, the way I treat the crowd, the spectators, my teammates, the opposition, that they're watching that. They're watching that every move. And that is one thing that, you know, sportsmanship my whole life has been incredibly important to me. And I encourage that on the field. When I bring umpires in and stuff, you know, I say that's how I want the game delegated. That's most important to me. You know, I don't care if you can make a huge killer play, but if you're not fair and you're not nice to people on and off the field, you really don't have a place here with me.
I'm super excited to grow our show team, to do some local competitions, but also to travel to some bigger nationally rated horse shows. I'm also excited to hopefully host a Connecticut rated horse show here. Also, just, you know, just to see the whole program, may it be Hunter Jumper or Polo, flourish.
This year was, you know, pretty good. I got to meet a lot of different people with very, you know, horsemanship talent in polo. Very nice. Got to play quite a bit, you know, and this year's been really good polo, you know, better players, better horses. So the whole summer was good.
So my hope for 2021 is to take polo lessons and start to play.
Everyone always says, like, when are you going to get a real job, or are you going to do a real job? This is a real job. Like, I mean, you're working with your hands and you're working with, like, your heart, you know. And it's incredible, you know, and it's unlike anything. I mean, I wouldn't want to do anything else besides work with these horses and these people that I love and care about.
I think 2020 presented an open door, and through that door of unknown and uncertainty, I think all of us were given, you know, this blank canvas with new colors, and we learned to create something from that. Everybody's hand was a part of what went into this year, and it is the start of something that is only going to become bigger and stronger. And I think sometimes you really got to take that step back to lay that foundation and make sure that the strength and the core and the integrity is there. And I think 2020 has given FPC that.